Guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is very exciting. As you can tell by the title, me and my family recently got a dog. She is a little puppy. She's really sleepy right now, so I don't know if I can get her to get in the frame for very long. This video is just gonna be talking a little bit about her, how we got her, what we feed her, how we train her. I am definitely not a dog trainer or a dog expert, so do not take everything I say in this video as a fact. I'm sorry, I'm putting you through this. So her name is Matcha. We went back and forth on like a few names. We were gonna name her Hazel for a while, but then we thought that Hazel was like too basic, so then we went with Matcha. And because her name is Matcha, we try to get her things that are green like her collar, her leash, and like stuff like that. So we got her from someone that we know. They accidentally had a litter in their house from like their two dogs. Ouch. Ouch.
Okay.
As you can see, she is a biter. We picked her up about a month ago because today is, ouch, oh my gosh. What? Because today is July 18th while I'm filming this, and we picked her up June 20th. And her birthday is April 22nd. So she's almost 3 months old. In the litter that they had, she has an older sister and brother, I believe, because I think she's the youngest. Her mom is a miniature Klee Kai Husky, I believe. I think that's what her breed is. And then her dad is a Golden Doodle. We think that she'll be around 40 pounds-ish because her dad is about, I think, 50 pounds. But her mom is around 25. Right now she's almost 20, I would say. I think she's about like 17, 18. And she's less than 3 months old. So she's growing pretty quickly, as do all puppies. And downstairs she has her playpen and her crate, which is like right next to me. And we have a futon laid right next to her because we used to sleep downstairs with her during like the first week or week and a half. We would all take turns. Each of us would sleep down here with her because she would wake up around maybe like 4, like to go pee. So one of us has to let her out and then she'll go back to sleep, and then she'll wake up around 5:30 or 6 and you have to let her out again. But now we don't sleep down here with her. We just come down at like 5:30 now. So we put her to sleep around 10 or 11 and like make sure she's asleep. And then we all go upstairs, sleep in our own rooms. And then whoever is on duty that night or that morning has to come down and let her out around 5:30. And we have a little like doggy cam downstairs so we can see if she's awake or not. She was biting us a lot when we first got her. I have like some bite marks on me, like on my wrist area, and then she kind of bit me this morning, or not really bite me. I was trying to get a tennis ball out of her mouth and I scraped her teeth. So she took out a little chunk of skin and she scratched me the other day. So now I have this, but we cut her nails finally. So her claws are a little bit better now. And oh, I'll show you guys a few things that we feed her. So for dry food like kibble, we feed her this Blue Buffalo, I think it's a life protection plan, the chicken and brown rice recipe. But we also feed her the wet version, which is this, the Blue Buffalo homestyle recipe chicken dinner with garden vegetables. She is obsessed with this stuff. We feed her 3 times a day, like 6 a.m., 12 p.m., and 6 p.m. And we feed her half a cup of kibble, and then I mix in about like 2 scoops of her canned food. And then for her treats, this is a new bag I just picked up, but we feed her these chews. Like, they're not rawhide though, because there's like mixed reviews about if rawhide is bad for dogs or not, because I think they can get salmonella or something. But these are the Smart Bones No Rawhide Twists, wrapped with chicken and made with real peanut butter. So it's peanut butter on the inside and then it has like chicken wrapped on the outside. She really likes these. I feed her one of these every day basically. There's a lot of options at the store. Like buying food, buying treats for dogs is honestly so overwhelming. Even though we've had dogs before, but there are so many options out there. The internet says so many things, the vet says so many things. And then we also feed her some chicken breast, which we just steam ourselves. and I just shred them up into little pieces and then I put them in this container. We used to feed her these training treats, which I don't have them with me right now. I'll put a picture up here. It's the Blue Buffalo Bit Soft training treats, I think. They're like little heart shapes, they're kind of cute. And there's like a chicken one, a beef one, a fish one, and a lamb one, I think. But we just feed her mostly chicken stuff because it's the most common and most basic, I guess. We just feed her everything in regular bowls, but we got her this swirly bowl. But she's too little to eat from this right now because the bowl is like really deep, and we let her try it out, but it didn't seem like she can reach the food in there. But these bowls are really nice because it slows down their eating by like a lot. In her playpen, she has her bed, and then her crate, she has another bed. She really likes this toy that we bought her. It's really sad looking now because she's bit through it so badly. Like one of the squeakers came out of one of his arms because it's supposed to squeak like that. And we got her just a regular Kong collar, like from the brand Kong, and then we got her just the most simple dog tag ever, just like the silver one. We went to PetSmart like a few days before we were gonna pick her up. We were looking at dog tags for a good 10 minutes, and we ended up picking the most basic one. Along with her collar, she has a little harness. It's not like a padded one, it's just like the basic, like around the stomach and like the back one. And then she has this little skinny leash that we bought for her, but we also have a bigger one for when she gets big. We put on her harness for a few hours a day just so she can get used to it, and then sometimes we leash her up and just let her like walk around. Like, we're not necessarily like taking her for a walk, but we've been potty training her and like house training her and stuff. She's definitely had accidents in the house, quite a few, but I think she's getting better. Like, she'll like stand by the door to our backyard if she like really needs to go, and we're teaching her like basic commands like sit, down, drop it, like for toys and stuff.
So there she is. Let me move this pillow. There she is. Look. Isn't she so cute? People think she looks old because she has a lot of like white and silver fur. So yeah, we have like a little green collar for her, and her harness is also green, and then her leash is just black.
So this is her crate slash playpen situation. So she has a pad in there, and then her bed, and then like a bunch of her toys. And then the crate is connected to the playpen, so she can just go in like that. But yeah, I think I'm just gonna end the video here. She is dead asleep and I don't want to wake her. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next one.